OMG, look at that pocket of pus in the gum. So you want to watch it drain, right? Well, you'll get to that here. But if you want to do more than just that, stay till the end of the video where we'll do a comprehensive review of dental infections, treatment, and follow-up. Hello and welcome to another video by Dr. Carlo Oger, board-certified emergency physician, and the new domain, DrER.tv. Please make sure you watch this video all the way to the end. I have some nice educational slides at the end. Well, let's talk about this patient. As you can see, he has severe dental disease and gum disease, something called acute necrotizing ulcerative gingivitis. You can see that the enamel is decayed, he has caries everywhere, and this is developed into an odontogenic infection. That means the infection or this abscess in the gum developed from bacteria getting into that gingiva and then localizing in the gum or soft tissue. Because it's abscess, it needs to be drained. The body can't really clear it all that well in there. Sometimes the abscesses are not easily accessible and you just have to treat with oral antibiotics and such. But this one is very accessible, so we're going to go ahead and inject him with some plain lidocaine. This is kind of fast forward a little bit to go through it quickly. And this was plain lidocaine, not buffered with bicarb, which should help with the pain of injection. That's something I'm currently working on my facility to obtain on a routine basis. But you can see the second injection was a lot better tolerated. Now I'm pushing on it with my finger, making sure it's nice and numb. And eventually the patient even checks on the outside to make sure he's numb. I'm checking to make sure there's no other pain anywhere else. It's kind of difficult to hold the lip up, so I'm using the gauze to kind of give me some traction and give me some access into that abscess of the upper gum on this patient. So he's there helping me to hold it open because I was having a lot of trouble holding. And there I am using a blade to kind of cut and obtain the abscess. Don't worry if you didn't see it. I'm going to do a slow motion and a little zoomed in so you can see, but definitely a lot of pus being obtained from that abscess drainage. You can see the blade cutting that just at the top of the flocculus right there, just a nick in the skin of the gum. And there it goes. You know, over time I've learned how better to do these things, and usually this would have been better with suction instead of a gauze, because then as it opens up, the patient doesn't have to taste it. It doesn't go all over his mouth, because I can only imagine how bad that must taste. But so when I do these now, I usually do suction instead of a gauze. It helps the patient's comfort, and they don't have to taste the pus as it comes out. As you can see, it kept coming out, so I was leaving the gauze there to absorb, but it wasn't doing a very good job, so he had to spit out, clean it up. And here I go with a gauze to clean up the area, make sure I'm milking most of the infection out. As an outpatient, I'm going to tell him to do warm gargles with half hot water, half peroxide, and of course use oral antibiotics and follow up. So here I'm using the gauze to kind of milk and make sure I got all of the abscess, and then use the gauze to kind of tuck it in there and slow the bleeding of the injection down. But don't stop watching this video, even though it's almost done. I have some really good educational slides about dental infections that's definitely worth watching. A dental alveolar abscess is an acute lesion characterized by localized pus in the structures that surround the tooth. The term dental alveolar abscess comprises actually three distinct processes as follows. A periapical abscess that originates in the dental pulp and is usually secondary to dental caries is the most common dental abscess in children. Dental caries erode the protective layers of the tooth, i.e. the enamel and the dentin, and allow bacteria to invade the pulp, producing pulpitis. Pulpitis can progress to necrosis with bacterial invasion of the alveolar bone, causing an abscess. A periodontal abscess involves the supporting structures of the teeth, the periodontal ligaments, and alveolar bone. This is the most common dental abscess in adults, but may occur in children with impaction of a foreign body in the gingiva. Pericoronitis describes the infection of the gum flap that overlies a partially erupted or impacted third molar. odontogenic infections are polymicrobial, with an average of 4 to 6 different causative bacteria. The dominant isolates are strictly anaerobic gram-negative rods and gram-positive cocci. Most dental abscesses respond to surgical treatment, incision and drainage, root canal or extraction, and the elimination of the source of infection. The addition of antibiotics is not recommended for a localized dental abscess. Antibiotics are indicated if drainage is not possible or if the patient shows signs of systemic involvement or is immunocompromised. The duration of therapy should be 7 days. Penicillin VK. Pen VK, 500 milligrams orally 3 times a day. Penicillin G, which is a shot, 2 to 4 million units. Amoxicillin clavulanate, which is augmentin, and clindamycin are reasonable choices for treatment of dental infections. And that's it for tonight, DrER.tv. If you don't know about this channel yet, please subscribe. You can see 135,000 subscribers, 54 million views. I just have fun doing it, teaching. Check out DrER.tv.